guys, thanks for joining me. Today I'm gonna do something a little bit different, and these will eventually turn into projects that I can use with my scan and cut machine, and sometimes my embroidery machine. And those are gonna be what we'll call advanced projects. But for now, I just wanna show you guys this new technique that I've learned that I'm in love with, and it's really fun, it's really easy, and it will make you feel like you're the most amazing artist, even if you've never picked up a paintbrush. Okay, so it's called acrylic pouring or fluid painting. There's all kinds of different names for it, but it's mostly acrylic pouring. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna layer colors in a cup. We're gonna turn that cup upside down on the canvas. And then we're going to lift the cup and let things go where they may. So first, what we're going to need for this specific, what I'm doing today, is going to be the canvas. You can also do it on ceramic tile, and you can do it on wood, and I'm sure a bunch of different other things. Right now we have some garden fabric wrapped around a frame, and Christian has gessoed it to see if we can use that instead of buying the canvases, because canvases are very expensive. And if we can make our own out of garden fabric, woo, it's gonna be so cool. All right, and so flood Floetrol is something else that we're gonna be using. And that is, I'll show you instead of trying to explain it. We're gonna have our acrylic paints. You can use really high quality ones, or you can use the junk from the dollar store. Shouldn't have said junk. The stuff from the dollar store, because it's pretty much just the good stuff watered down most of the time. So aluminum foil is what I have for my boat to catch all this. I have a scrapbook, like a little plastic scrapbook bin that I use for the smaller ones, but this one is too big. So what I did was I just put two of them next to each other, and then I lifted up the sides and rolled it, and then I put another one down just in case it wanted to try to get out. And that's just my white paint. I have it in a bottle because I want to use a lot of it. We have jumbo woodcraft sticks, but I would suggest just getting small stir sticks. I'm just using what we have. These are my colors for today. I'm going to be using plaid. Ooh, why doesn't it want to get it? Okay, well, they're all plaid. They're all from like Walmart and Fred Meyer and stuff like that. So I have two neon colors. It says glow, but they're not glow in the dark. They're just neon. And I'm gonna use some gold and some purple. And this is my white, right? No, this is my white. But this, I hope that it will. This is called iridescent medium. And you can put it in your colors, and it gives your colors that iridescence. So that's really cool. So you're going to want some cups, as many cups as you're going to be using to paint. You're going to want those. Plus, you're going to want four cups to go underneath your canvas, okay? To kind of hold it up and let things drip in so it doesn't stick to the aluminum foil. I have a paper plate just to set all of my stuff on, you know, all of my stuff with paint on it. I also have some glitter to add, you know, later if I want to. And the optional stuff is this micro torch. And we got this at Harbor Freight. And the silicone oil we got on Amazon. And you really don't need very much at all. I've really messed up a lot of paintings by using too much. So you don't need very much of that at all. I like to wipe my hands on a rag when I'm done instead of trying to run and wash them. And whenever you first do your pouring, you're going to want gloves because it's going to get really messy. So that's all the stuff we need to start. I'm going to get the camera set up, and I'll show you how to mix the Floetrol with your paints in a second, okay? Be right back. Okay, so I'm back with my cups, and this is the Floetrol, okay? It's a latex-based paint additive, okay? And we got one quart on Amazon. I don't even remember how much it was, but I know that it was expensive for just this little bottle. So I went looking around, and what do they call it? Home Depot has it for $13 for a gallon, which is an amazing deal, but they didn't have any locally for me. So then I went to our other local store that's like Home Depot, but it's just for our area. It's called Jerry's, and they had the gallon for $15. So just look around for it if you can't find it where you are. Look around in maybe some obscure places that might not have an online category or an online catalog, but you can go in the store and see. And it'll be by the paint sprayers. Like, I don't know if you've seen paint sprayers, but okay. So the cool thing about this stuff is you put a little bit into a cup or a lot, depending on what colors you're going to be using. Okay. And I want just a tiny bit for my yellow. So I'm going to fill all these up with just a little bit and a couple of them with a lot. Okay. And I've already mixed my white up in this, so it's easy to use for me because I like to use a lot of white sometimes. And I have a black one like that too. Okay, so you know whenever you go into the store and you want to buy a thing of paint, you go to like Home Depot or Lowe's and you want to buy a thing of paint and you pick the base. You get the base off of the shelf and you take it up to the people and they add the pigment, which is just the paint, and then they put it in the paint shaker. Oops, but I don't have one. And then you just put it and you mix it up, okay? And your color is gonna come back. My hot pink will come back once it's all mixed in. You won't even see the gesso. The Floetrol. So mix it up really good. Don't worry about your air bubbles. The air bubbles are actually going to make the painting cool. Okay, so I'm going to finish getting all of my paints ready and then I'll be right back. Okay, now I'm back with my clean cup without any paints in it. Okay, so I have all of my paints done. They're all over here. And I want to apologize for Lucky in advance. He is whining to go outside and he doesn't go outside. So it goes on forever. I went ahead and after I used my stir sticks, I just kind of wiped them off on the side of the painting because it's all going to get covered anyways. So just set your stir sticks aside. I'm going to layer these with contrasting colors and sometimes same colors just for effect, okay? So first we're going to add white, just layer the whole bottom, and you want to fill this entire cup. If you have a little cup, you want it filled all the way to the top. Okay, and with the oil, you're going to mess around with it a little bit because you don't want more than one drop right at the very beginning. Come. Oop. Well, that sucked. It went on the side. But it's still going to go in the paint, so I'm not going to mess with it again or put too much oil in it because too much oil in it kind of messes up the painting to me. Okay, so I'm going to go straight from white to a really dark color. Pretty purple. Okay, and then from purple, I'm going to go to pink. And then I'm going to add some more white. Kind of cover all that up. Okay, and then I'm going to put my robin's egg blue or whatever color that was. This, that's just a plain gloss. And then this one is like a seafoamy kind of green blue that also has the iridescent medium in it. Okay, and then I'm gonna do more white. And then I'm going to put our gold in. And I added the iridescent to, oh no, I didn't add it to the gold. The gold is already has the shine. And I only want a little bit of this fluorescent yellow. Okay. All right, so my cup is at the top and we're going to get everything set up. I'll show you how to flip the canvas. So whenever it's like this, you just take your canvas, turn it upside down, and then you turn your whole cup over with it. That was really hard to do in the video. Oh my gosh, my fingerprints. Okay, and then you just let your cup set for at least a minute. Okay, so we'll be right back. Okay, so there's two of us trying to do this, and if we mess up, I'm really sorry. But here we go, okay? And then you take your excess and just kind of get it around the edges. Something I meant to do was paint my corners first. And then right now is when you're going to want to use your torch and try to blow out the big bubbles. So those air bubbles that are created when you're mixing your paint, they're going to layer and make these really cool cells. Okay. And the oil helps a lot to do the big cells, but you will get little cells even if you don't have the oil. But I know that I want this to mostly be purple and pink. Are you able to keep
it? Mm-hmm. Okay. I'm following you.
So this is how easy it is, guys. So I'm going to set this aside, or actually, I'm going to set this down, and I'm going to take some of the white that I put in the bottle, and I'm going to flood it.
Oh, that's a cool trick.
That way my corners, I don't lose all of my pretty stuff, and my corners can get covered without having to, a lot of the times when you're trying to cover the whole thing and try to do your corners, you lose all the pretty cool stuff in the middle. But as you can see, it's already really, really, really neat. So let's go over here. Oops. And put a towel underneath all the stuff that you're doing, because you're gonna be moving it around a little. Okay, so you just wanna keep tilting it till you get your whole canvas covered.
It's coming out really cool.
Okay. Okay, so it's almost done. It just has to get this final corner. Okay.
Wow.
And it is done. Make sure you set the cups onto the wood part of the canvas so it's all even and not pushing through your canvas. I'll still need to wash my hands, but I like to just get the first round off with a rag. Okay, and then I'm going to take the torch again and just get all the places that might not be coming out yet. So this just opens up the air bubbles. And if you see big air bubbles as it's drying, you could just grab your torch and pop it. Or you can use the toothpick and pop it. So that is all there is to it. I'm really excited to make more of these on canvas, but I'm really excited to do them on tile and stuff like that so that we can add scan and cut designs to it. That's kind of my end game with this, really. So anyways, I hope you guys found this really fun and helpful. Talk to you later. Bye. I know I already said goodbye, but I want to show you a handful of glitter. Don't try to get close and put your glitter in. You want to be really high so it has time to kind of be organic as it's falling. So I've got it in this one area. It's going to stay in this one area, but it's not going to be super thick anywhere. Okay, just wanted to give you guys that tip. See you later. Bye.